but they do get one new premium aircraft, and that is another Lend-Lease. If you've ever noticed about their premium aircraft, it is Soviet premium aircraft, and then Lend-Lease and captured. At the very end, you have a captured aircraft, a Focke-Wulf 190D9 that's 7,420 Golden Eagles. But one that I think I am going to be picking up with my Golden Eagles is for 1,900 Golden Eagles, you can pick up the Lend-Lease P-47D27. Holy tits. A P-47 for the Soviets. It looks absolutely ugly because it's got a Soviet camouflage on it and red stars all over it, but it's still a P-47, carrying 850 caliber machine guns, 12.7mm, with 3,400 rounds, sitting at a battle rating of 3.7 with that amazing premium reward. Now, this is a P-47D-27, which I believe the Americans don't even get one of those. No, the Americans carry a D-25 and a D-28. It's just like the Americans carry a J-1 and a J-20 for the B-25s when the Soviets get a J-30. So that's quite neat. I think I'm going to pick that up. But just like the Germans, the Soviets also have a ground forces. And this patch was very focused on ground forces. So let's take a look at the new ground forces. Oh my god, there's loads of new tanks. Oh, breathe. Just breathe in. Breathe out. Okay, let's take a look. In the first tech tree, we get nothing new. Actually, yes, we do. We get the new... Oh, God, what one is it? This one. What the... I didn't know there was a 1951 tank in here. Okay. The first new vehicle here is a new T-54, the Mod 1947, which is an earlier variant of the 1951 modification, with a slightly different-looking turret... The sort of triangular-looking turret. It's basically not a T-54. It's basically a T-44 with a different turret. I mean, look, the chassis is... That chassis is definitely crying T-44 there. It carries one 100mm D-10 T cannon with 34 rounds and a giant butt gun up there. Holy crap. It sits at a battle rating of 8.0, so it's going to be up there with the higher tier... vehicles. I've never had a chance to drive up there that high tier, but I know it's Soviet, but I still want to drive it. Show the armor here. Oh my god, that... Oh, I was about to say that's really crap, but then I saw it said 122mm. 200mm! Oh god, go away. Just stop it. I'm done looking at it. Okay, moving on. There is no new heavy tanks. No new heavy tanks, no new light tanks there, no new tank destroyers. But they do get two new AA vehicles in their standard tech tree, starting with the ZSU-37, which carries a 37mm 61K cannon and is the strangest looking tank. I mean, look how skinny that barrel is! Holy crap, look how skinny that is! That's like a... What the heck? Oh, gross. Ugh, the SU-37, I really don't like that tank. Or that tank destroyer. And this thing just looks ugly. I'm going to be honest. It looks ugly. But, it carries 137mm cannon with 290 rounds. And it's open-topped, so very vulnerable. You can see the seats in there. Show armor. Yeah, 35mm. This thing's going to be knocked out in one shot. By basically almost everything. That's basically how the SU-30 goes. SU-37. Or SU-76, I mean, not SU-37. Alright, and the next AA vehicle sits at battle rating 8.0, way up there, and that is the ZSU-57-2. This monstrosity of a giant square thing on a T-54 chassis. I believe that's a T-54 chassis. If not, it's a T-44 chassis. But look at this thing. Look at the size of those guns. That's got a dual 57mm S-68 cannon with 248 rounds. Open-topped again. But this thing, it's just, wow. I mean, again, it's maybe Soviet, but those are still two big, really, really big guns. A whole 13.5mm of armor. 15mm of armor. And this thing sits at a battle rating of... Oh, God, this thing is going to do horribly. Wow. This thing is... Wow, that's almost sad. Although, it could also be, you know, the best thing at that tier. I can't believe the cannon barrels have the thickest armor on the entire vehicle. Because it has such thin armor, you know, tank shells are going to go right through and come out the other end, doing minimal damage, unless they're using high explosives. So this thing's going to be an interesting vehicle. Look at all that ammunition down there. All right, and that's it for standard Soviet vehicles, but they also get three new premium vehicles. One including a new premium AA vehicle, the ZU-T-37, which is based on the chassis of the T-60, I believe, or the T-70, one of the two. And it carries a single 37mm SH-37 cannon with 200 rounds. But I mean, it's cool. It's a very low tier, 3.0 battle rating, but it's a premium AA vehicle. You know, it's something that you don't really have yet, and it's something that if you like driving AA vehicles, here you go, you have a premium one for yourself. That costs 1,000 golden eagles. Armor, that's what I expected. There you go. Again, if you want to look at this more detail, I'll definitely be doing that, but on my own time. Then load up the game for yourself. The next one is only 550 golden eagles, and it's a captured German tank, the T3, which is a captured Panzer III vehicle. There it is. With a 50mm KWK-38 cannon, which is in itself a really, really dangerous cannon, but it's not the long-barreled, skinny one, so it's not a super high-velocity cannon. So it's probably not going to be as devastating as the German one. Yeah, it has same armor, though, and same crew placement. Now, in their original screenshot, there was a hammer and sickle down here. It's a good thing they took that out, otherwise I would have been really, 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 really mad about that. So yeah, there you go. Only 550 eagles. I'm probably not gonna pick that up. But here's something I am going to be picking up. Everybody's calling it the Tog II of War Thunder. And you know why it's called the Tog II? Because it looks like one, it drives like one, and it feels like one. And yes, of course, I'm talking about the Leviathan, the T-35 Soviet multi-turreted World War I grade heavy tank. This thing is big. It is slow. It's got multiple gun turrets. It's big, and it's slow, and it's got multiple gun turrets. It carries, are you ready for this? One 76mm KT-28 cannon with 96 rounds, and two 45mm 20K cannons with 113 rounds each, but separate. I believe that's a 76mm short-barreled gun on top, and two 45mm cannons, one in front, and one in back. Holy crap. The armor is poop. 30 millimeters. This thing's gonna be knocked out instantly, again. But it's just gonna be so fun to drive. Look at that. Look how many people are in there. Holy crap. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 guys in there, shoved right in the same tank. Oh, that's almost scary. I don't want to know what's going on in there. If somebody drops the soap. Wow, this vehicle, I want to buy it so bad. It's only sitting at a battle rating of 2.3. Thing is you take that really, really thin armor for the fact that you're firing three guns at the enemy at once, if you have the correct angle. I believe if you sit at an angle of this, pointing this way, and this way, then you can fire all three at once. But wow, that's really neat. I'm going to have to learn how to use those cannons. So that's it for the Soviet Ground Forces tech tree. Moving on to the British, which get some new aviation. Not much. The British don't really get much love patches now. They get what? A whole two new standard aircraft and one premium plane. That's all they get this entire patch. They get three standard aircraft. So a total of four aircraft total. So let's start off with the standard aircraft. In the bomber line, they get two new bombers. The first being the Lancaster B Mark I. So, we already had the Lancaster Mark III in the game, and now we get the Lancaster Mark I. I have no idea what the differences are. The Lancaster Mark I carries a quad 30 cal in the back, dual 30 cal up front, or on top, and a dual 30 cal there. I'm not going to take a look at what kind of bombs it uses, see if there's any differences, but the point is the British now get a new Lancaster to use. Oh, and there's the flags in the background. So that's kind of cool. I do know the Lancaster Mark III got a change. Let me take a look at that. Yeah, I do have a custom camouflage on it. Yeah, it doesn't. It no longer has a quad 30 cal in the back. It now carries a dual 12.7 millimeter M2 Browning machine gun, which is somewhat better, but at the same time not, in my opinion. But oh well, just my opinion. But they also get a new jet bomber, the fourth ever jet bomber in the game, the British version. This is the Canberra B Mark II, which is basically a British B-57. Although I believe the British are the ones who made the aircraft, so don't quote me on that. So this thing carries, I believe, the same payload. I'm not sure. It looks pretty similar. You can definitely tell it looks pretty similar. That nice, thin, sleek look to it. Let me see. Modifications. No, this thing can carry even more bombs. 9 500-pound bombs default. It can carry 6 1,000-pound bombs, but it can also carry 2 1,000-pound bombs and a 4,000-pound bomb. So that's depending on if you're wanting to bomb bases or if you want to bomb ground targets, you know. Wow, that's really cool. And they also get a new jet fighter. Everybody remembers the notorious Vampire FB Mark V, but they now have a Venom FB Mark IV, which is supposed to be quicker, more maneuverable, and just better in every single way than the Vampire. It also looks a bit cooler. It basically looks exactly the same to the Vampire, only it has fuel things on the side, or unless those are radars, I don't know. And it also has just a little of an antenna there, you know, everything comes equipped with this thing. And it's got, of course, the quad 20mm Hispano cannons in the nose, as usual. It just looks really, really, really cool. I really like just the look of it. So, that's it for standard aircraft for the British. Let's take a look at their only new premium aircraft, a low-tier bomber, the Catalina Mark IV-A. That's right, it's a flying boat, it's a medium bomber, it's a torpedo bomber for 880 Golden Eagles. You can have yourself an American low-altitude British Lend-Lease aircraft, carrying all the same payloads, I believe. Yeah, all the way up to... Oh no, 4 1,000-pound bombs and 2 torpedoes. So really, really neat. And this is actually something I was quite happy about. No, don't test flight. I was actually quite happy about because the British don't get much for low-tier bomber aircraft. They get the Beaufort and the Blenheim. And if you pay for Golden Eagles, you get the Whirlaway, which is crap. Well, it depends. It's crap for me because I don't really care for it. But it may not be crap for you. And then the Havoc, which is a ground attack aircraft. But now they got the PBY, which is really good for arcade battles. You know, realistic battles, maybe not so much, unless you're into PBYs and realistic battles. But it's just nice to have another low-tier bomber aircraft. So that's for 880 Golden Eagles. That is a really nice addition. I'm not sure if I'll pick that one up. I'm actually kind of thinking about it, because, you know... But, guys, moving on to our last section of new aircraft in the game, which sit in the Japanese tech tree. Everybody knows the Japanese don't get much love each patch. They definitely got love this patch. Let's take a look at their new aircraft. Oh, yes, look at this. So much new stuff. So much new stuff. Oh, my God, I'm going to cry. Okay. Taking a look at the first tech tree. Nope, just kidding. At the second tech tree, down our KI line, our